to your visiting public. Now, a few. How's that possible when there are over 1 billion disabled people around the world? How come we don't see them? Why they are not involved in social activities? Why they are not in their families? Hamyarameh is a startup that has been organized by a disabled person. Actually, it's a website that you can introduce yourself and your eligibility there, and you can describe how it can help a disabled person. As amazing as it is, I started thinking that why do they need this website? Why it was just designed for disabled people? Why it wasn't organized by non-disabled ones? After some time, I only found one answer for my questions. Their needs haven't been answered, even the primary ones. For instance, essential social facilities for disabled people in society. It's visible that this group of people haven't been considered at all. Let's take a look at some examples. This is actually our old university stairs. Too many stairs with no ramps for disabled people. So imagine you have studied so hard and you have gotten accepted in your favorite university. But when you get there, the first thing you would realize is that you can't even get through all classes. But luckily, these days, our new ones have this kind of facilities for us. In my country, in some cities, only 30% of drugstores, 25% of restaurants, 20% of cultural centers, and only 10% of buses are usable for this group of society. By the way, this is not just about my country. World Health Survey data from 51 countries has revealed that people with disabilities were more than 4 times likely to be treated badly. For example, in high-income countries, between 20% and 40% of people with disabilities generally do not achieve assistance for their needs during their everyday activities. Did you know that deaf people have trouble accessing sign language interpretations? Survey of 93 countries found that 31 of them have no interpreting service, while others have 20 or fewer qualifications. Even about transportation, being unable to access to public transportation is one of the most important reasons for a disabled person to be discouraged about finding a job or to be prevented from accessing healthcare. Now imagine our buses. Are they accessible for a disabled person to get on them? Or if they are, is there a place for them to sit? Moreover, they are not in a good condition in society. They don't get the attention and respect that they deserve and are usually more likely to be affected by negative attitudes. Attitudes that can affect their level of social interaction, access to public services, and even personal matters, like their education. What about conditions like working age? In some countries, disabled people's working age is 2 times higher and are usually more likely to be unemployed. Also, when they are employed, they are more probable to work part-time, unless they're highly educated than anyone else. With all of these horrible examples, we still have some good ones too. For example, some companies like Fruits Factory employ disabled people, and they actually believe that disability doesn't have to be a barrier for finding a job. I think the most important reason that these things are happening is that we don't know. Actually, we don't want to. For the unfair society, disabled people live in an acknowledged and abandoned difficulties. Understanding the number of people with disabilities and their circumstances can actually improve efforts to remove disabling barriers and to provide better services for allowing them to participate. I suppose at the beginning, you all thought I was going to talk about disabled people, and I mentioned disabled brains. But it is our own brain which is disabled. Nowadays, as a society, we don't have enough knowledge about different disabilities. We don't have faith in disabled people, we don't believe in them, and actually we don't think of them. They're not even humans. That's what I call a disabled brain. But we can increase our knowledge about disabilities, we can make their condition and facilities better, and we can encourage them and help them. These days, with social media, everything is possible. We can share their talents and use hashtags to publish videos or photos. And above all, we can give them the support that they need. At the end, I would love to take a look at what Professor Seven Hawkins said. It is my hope that beginning with the Convention of the Rights of People with Disabilities and publications like World Report, this century will make a turning point for inclusion of people with disabilities.